Hi guys, it's Jama Malmi. Welcome to another scrapbook process video. Today I'm going to be scrapbooking 11 photos on a double page layout. So I've got some hiking photos here and I was really excited when I saw the May stamp of the month because it's got this really fun mountain range on it and there's even a tree here. And so I'm going to incorporate that in my layout today. I'm going to show you a couple of techniques that I love and I've shared here before, but in case you haven't seen them, we're going to use flip flaps to fit three photos in one photo spot. And then we are also going to introduce a pocket plus insert that will allow me to add four extra photos. So that's going to be these photos right here. So I'm going to go ahead and set these ones aside because we're not going to need that yet. And these ones, what we want to scrapbook is the one that's going to be on the base. And then these ones are going to be in a flap that's going to lift up to reveal. So this is the one I want on top. I'm going to set that aside along with this one that will be in the flap also. And so those will be set aside and it's going to be these five photos that actually go on the double spread. So let's go ahead and set these aside. And what I'm planning to use is this Hope and Kindness set, which if you look at it, you might not think hiking photos at first. It's got some really, really beautiful florals. But if you look at the colors, we've got the craft color and a couple colors of green and like a yellowy color and a brown. And so if I leave out the florals and stick to maybe even leave some florals. I might even use this floral, but like this one is going to be really great for what I'm doing. And then we've got some cardstock here. And this cardstock is special because it's not textured to the feel, but it's got a textured look. And each side is a little different. This one has sort of like brush strokes on a like linen look background. And then this one is more of just like a distressed looking linen background. And so there's one of these for each of the featured colors in the collection. And then there's also these craft sheets. So I think I'm going to use this and maybe the green for my mountain range. So this is what it looks like on both sides. There's two sheets and they each have a front and back. I really, really love this one. It's just craft on one side or a textured craft. And then I'm gonna save these ones because I wanna use those as base pages for a different layout. So that's what the cardstock pack looks like. This collection is available through May and there's some coordinating doilies and some die cut pieces. I punched these all off of the sheet that it came on. And so these craft die cut shapes are probably gonna be brought in as well. And then we also have these doily shapes, which are gorgeous, but I don't think it's gonna go with my hiking photos, but just thought I'd show you because it is part of the special. So let's go ahead and clear this off and we'll get started on the layout. So I brought in my two VersaMats, which I love working on because it really helps line things up and also make sure I stay in frame on the camera for you. And then I brought in this Make It From Your Heart Volume 5. This is one of Close to My Heart's how-to books. It's got sketches that have blueprints and actual cutting diagrams, so you know exactly how to cut the papers, and then a couple of examples as well. And I was thinking these triangles kind of resemble mountains, and these grid style layout could work with my photos. So I've sort of laid my photos out how I want them. I'm going to leave this area for my title. I brought in white base pages and then a few of the patterns that I was considering. I wasn't sure about the stripes. There are some of those pink tones in mine and my son's shirts, but I didn't know if I wanted to bring those out with the pattern paper or not, so I'm just kind of setting it aside. I'm looking at the guide and it's telling me to cut the big triangles at 6 1/4 by 10. So I knew I wanted to use this dark green paper for the larger triangles, so I'm gonna go ahead and commit and cut that down to size. It's really easier than it looks. You just cut the large rectangle to size and then you cut that rectangle at a diagonal to create the triangles. And so each of the larger triangles are the same pattern out of the larger rectangle, and then the smaller triangles are out of the same pattern as well
out of a smaller rectangle. So it's actually really easy to put this together. So I fussed around a bit trying to figure out how to orient the triangles, but first I want to figure out which other pattern to use. I auditioned that down there and I just thought, it did match my photos, but it didn't do anything to bring them out. So I tried this craft background with floral paper and I was liking that, and I wasn't planning to bring in so much floral, but I think it really works with the colors. Then I decided to try out some of these cardstocks, and I just thought it didn't add enough interest. I really liked that craft background and decided to go with the flowers. I'm going to use the cardstock as my photo mats and also to do my stamping. So I cut that rectangle down to size and then into the two triangles, and then I'm going to fuss for a bit trying to decide where I want to orient my triangles. I didn't like them both on the bottom because then they are placed the same with the green on the right and the floral on the left. So then I thought I would try the triangles on the top on one, and I didn't really like that. It didn't resemble mountains, and I didn't like the way the patterns were placed. So I ended up deciding on having each one on the side, and I was liking that. Now we're going to get into our stamping. So the reason I was so excited about this stamp set is because that mountain range is perfect for Colorado, which is where we live, and I wanted to make a scene that resembled the Rockies, which is where this hike was at. So I decided to stamp the mountain range first onto that textured craft cardstock. So I want to give you some stamping tips here to help you have successful stamping onto your project. First, I have that foam down, and that helps give some cush when you're stamping. I'm going to put my paper on top of it right here. And then you saw me seasoning my stamp onto my hand. Since I haven't used this stamp yet, I was just kind of like smushing it on my hand to get some oils on it and get any manufacturing gunk off. And now I have some scrap paper out, and my first stamp is going to be on that scrap paper just to test it out and make sure it's stamping well. And it is. So now I'm ready to stamp onto my project. So I'm inking up the stamp really well, and then I'm going to press down, straight down with firm pressure without rocking. Leave it down for just a few seconds so that ink has time to soak in, and then lift it up, and we have a perfect impression. Now I want to line this mountain range up next to the one that's right there, and it's easy to do because of that straight line in the middle and because the end of the mountain and the horizon don't come together at the end, so you can line up the mountains with the mountains. And so that looks so awesome. I'm so happy with how it's looking. So to make it look more like the Rockies, I'm adding some trees. And this is one thing I was surprised about when we moved to Colorado, which was just this past fall, is that the Rockies are very brown. There are a lot of pine trees, but they're kind of sparse because there are so many rocks in the Rockies. Go figure. So there was a lot of dirt and rocks, and then some pine trees that were kind of sparse because it was so rocky. So I'm kind of trying to imitate that look. I'm putting the trees kind of, you know, halfway up on the line of the mountains as well, because of course that's how they grow. They're not just at the base. So I was sure to put them, you know, halfway up too. I'm cutting off that sun or moon, whatever you want to look at it as, because I don't need it. I just want the mountain range. And because this is pretty simple line art in the stamp, it's really easy to just cut that out. And then I cut that reflection off too, because I don't need that. I want that just to be at the base of my page. So I did that multiple times with the craft paper and the green paper, which I added mostly just for some contrast. And then that reflection that's at the bottom of the mountain, I actually cut that out too. And that's with those little smaller pieces. So right here, this is that reflection that I had cut off from the bottom of the horizon. And I'm going to use that as well to kind of tuck in and add some extra layers in these mountain ranges. I'm so, so excited with how this is turning out. It's even better than I imagined it in my head. To make it look even more realistic, I'm going to ink around the edges. I'm using a desert sand ink, which is retired. You'd want to use toffee here, which is the current ink color that's similar to this. I inked around the top, the bottom, and now I'm adding little dabs of ink in the middle where you see those lines to add even extra depth on these mountains. And it looks so awesome. I'm really loving it. I use this same ink to ink around the edges of every single one of these pieces. Even on the green pieces, I used this same ink and it gave that nice texture. So there's this sentiment on the stamp set that says, strength doesn't come from what you can do, it comes from overcoming the things you once couldn't. And this was perfect because my kids had kind of a hard time with this hike. It was a little bit more difficult than we were expecting. It was our very first hike after moving to Colorado, and we had planned to go to the Rocky Mountain National Park, but we had our dog with us and they didn't allow dogs. We didn't realize that. So we found another hike that was recommended to us that it was nearby in Estes Park, and we did it. So it was harder than we thought. It was pretty rocky, lots of rocks to kind of climb over, and got a little steep at the top, but we still had tons of fun. But the kids got very tired. We didn't finish. My son fell and scraped his knee, so that was a whole story for this journaling where he was holding his shorts, and that's what you see him doing in that one smaller photo where he held his shorts so they wouldn't get bloody, even though it wasn't that bloody, but he just insisted on holding his shorts the whole rest of the time. So we didn't make it to the top, but we made it really far and they did really well. So all that to say, that sentiment I think was really good for this page. And then there was another sentiment that says, you can do anything. And I end up adding that at the end of the layout as well. So I'm cutting my photos down just a hair so that they would fit on my 4x6 placeholder cards. I like to use those as mats sometimes. And then on the other side, I took some 5x7 placeholder cards and cut them down to 4 1/4 by 6 1/4 so I could keep my 4x6s the same size. And then I took a 4x6 placeholder mat and cut that down to 3.5 by 4.5. I left a larger border around the mat for that smaller photo because that's where the flip flap is going to be. And the flip flap takes up a little bit of extra space on the sides, so I wanted it to still have the same size mat. So for my title, I'm using this sticker that says, "Let your heart be your compass." And I thought that was perfect for a hiking photo. That introduced just a little bit of this corally pink color, which went with our shirts, as I mentioned earlier, but it didn't detract from the photos like using one of the papers that had more of that color in it did. I decided to swap where I was going to have the title. Because the title is sort of a bracket shape, I didn't want it right next to that bracket shape I stamped on. So I just moved it down and it was perfect. I put the sticker onto some cardstock to give it a little bit more stability because I wanted to put it on some foam. These stickers are cardstock stickers, but I just wanted it to have a little bit more stability than that. So I have a little bit of fun foam here because I wanted it to have a nice big even surface for the back of that. So I'm just going to peel off the backing, stick it on there, and I'm not gluing anything down. You may have noticed I haven't glued anything down yet because I still was just kind of indecisive about this layout, and I always end up adding embellishments or moving things around at the end, and then I have to peel things up. And so I thought, you know what, I'm just not going to glue anything down until I know I'm ready to commit toward the end. And so that's what I did. So I did decide that all of my mats are going to be matted in white, or all my photos are going to be matted in white, because that really helped them to pop off the page rather than having them straight onto that craft color. And I wanted that craft color on there though, because that really tied in with the rest of the layout and helped all that big photo block really pop off that white and green background. So I'm adding more fun foam on top of this other sticker that I ended up using that says "so beautiful," because this hike was so beautiful. And so I'm going to put this over here as kind of a subtitle. And I wanted that top die cut to pop off the page more. Because it is white on white, I thought I wanted to add a little bit of inking behind it. So I tested the sage first. It was a little lighter than I wanted. So then I used the New England Ivy, which is very similar to the pine color in this paper. And I'm starting right behind where the die cut's going to be, so you don't see that harsh line when you add the ink, and kind of spreading it out to just add some soft color. So I'm really liking how that's looking, but I want to add it in a few other points on the layout to create a visual triangle of that inking. So I decided to add a little bit under the title over here to draw your eye where the title is, and then under the So Beautiful subtitle as well. So I have that inking kind of behind all of the, you know, words like titles and subtitles that are on the page. And the visual triangle and just having all of that balance helps draw your eye across the page so you see all of the photos. So I decided to add a few stickers from the sticker sheet. And then we also have some of these craft die cuts from the die cut sheet. Now, I will say I wish I hadn't punched all of these die cuts out, because they were easier to see when they were on the big 12 by 12 sheet. They come on a big 12 by 12 sheet. It's like a light chipboard, heavy paperboard material. They're really, really beautiful die cuts that are easy to pop out but have very intricate detail. But I did like having them on the carrier sheet because it was hard to kind of dig through them here. So I'm not going to be doing that again. But I am finding some really good pieces that I like on the layout. I'm bringing out just a little bit more of that peach color. There's peach and papaya, I believe. So they're kind of similar colors, and I'm using those in little pops around the page to help draw your eye around the page. And trying out some various die cuts. That little circle peach sticker says you. So now this little heart says love. I'm going to pop that out so you can see it better. And it says love you. So I like that there, right with my son and I. And I didn't like that it was showing the paper in the background, because it was kind of a busy paper, that floral paper, to stick through the love. And then it's also covering the photo a little bit too. So I'm going to end up testing out a couple colors of cardstock to back that with. But first I'm trying out some other die cuts around the page and just adding a few little clusters. I found this peach flower and liked it down there by the title, and I'm using a few flowers but using them sparingly because I just didn't want a whole lot of them, but I think that they worked nicely on the page. So first I tried backing it with green. I did like that, but also wanted to try backing it with the peach, and that was a little too much for me, so I ended up going back to the green, and that's what I committed to. So I decided here to add some different leaves. I didn't like all of those leaves that had the kind of spread out leaves, sprawling leaves, if you will. And so I wanted to vary them a little bit, especially since the die cuts had those same kind of leaves too. So I put the die cut shape with the sticker that was a more solid leaf, and then the other side had that more sprawling leaf. I decided to cut out one of the flowers from that patterned paper because I wanted a little bit more peach over on this side of the page up in that corner. And I didn't have any more stickers to use except for these little itty bitty tiny ones that I did use and liked those. So now I feel like I've got balance around the page with that peach, and it's very minimal, so it doesn't take away from the photos. I think it just helps your eye move around the page and draws your eye to the photos because there's pops of that color in the photos as well. So I sped this up quite a bit as I glue everything down, just so you can kind of see my process. I'm just going to do the one side, and I'm not going to show all of it to you, but just some of these parts, like gluing that to the back of the die cut, showing you that I used this Barely Art glue with the thin nozzle to just kind of get under some of those leaves So I didn't have to lift them up. And the ones I did lift up, I put the glue just at the very end so that the glue part was hidden underneath that die cut. And then on the mountain range, I'm putting glue just at the base of the mountains because I'm going to be tucking in all of the other mountains above it. And I didn't want to glue the whole thing down so I could still tuck them back. But then in the end, I did go back and kind of stuck the nozzle of my glue under and glued down some of the backs as well. So I'm going to get those all in place. And by the way, the stamp of the month is available through the end of May, and it's only $5 with any $50 order from my Close to My Heart website. And there is a stamp of the month every single month. So this is the May, available for a few more days, and then it will change again in June. It is also available for free to my VIP customers. So if you are a VIP, you get this for free with a $50 order. And if you're interested in becoming a VIP, I'll have the information linked down below. It is a great deal. You get 15% back on all of your purchases, plus the free stamp of the month with your order. I'll also have all the products I use listed below. So I'm going to give you some close-ups here, but hang tight because we're going to add all of those extra photos. I'm going to show you how that comes together. This is where I'm going to add my journaling, which you'll see at the end in the still photos. And here is a look at that other side with all of that beautiful layering. I just love how this came together. So pretty. All right, so let's go ahead and add the flip-flop. So here are the two photos going in the flip-flop. I wanted to show you what the package looks like, and then we've got the two styles of flip-flops that both come in the package. So this is 3x4. It also comes in 4x6, 5x7, 4x4, 3x3, 2x2, even 6x12 and 8x12. There's tons of sizes. And so these ones, as I was showing you, can flip up, flip down, flip to the sides, it any way you want. You're going to sandwich your photos together with one upside down on the back. This is if you're going to be flipping it up. And then you're going to slide them into your little flip-flap here. Right now I have the sticky facing me, and then you're going to peel that release paper off, fold that little flap back, and place it right over your photo. So I line up the photo in the flip-flop right over the photo that's on the base page and stick it right to my page protector. These are really nice quality flip-flops and page protectors, so they're not going to be all floppy like some page protectors are. Now, this is the pocket plus insert that I added my extra photos to. I added the photos with the peach on the back because I wanted the more rocky photos on the front to match. I would love to know what types of photos you would add in these page inserts and flip-flops. I know you take tons of photos like I do, so let me know in the comments below what you could use these for. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you were inspired by this video, and if you were, please hit the like button and subscribe so you don't miss any upcoming scrapbooking videos. Here are a couple more videos I think you might enjoy, and I hope you have a wonderful day.